Dear students, in this video we will discuss the types of bolted connection in typical arrangement of this connection, failure of this connection, what is the caudal provision to design a bolted connection, and solve example of bolted connection. So in previous lecture of bolted connection, we will describe about the bolt properties and what are the caudal provision for different types of bolt. So in this video we continue with this same topic of bolted connection, subject elementary structural design, and describe about more two typical arrangement of bolted connection and failure of bolted connection and solve example. So starting with the some typical arrangement of connection arrangement. So in that, classify based on the types of force in a bolt. First one is lap joint, second one is butt joint. In that lap joint, there are the two types. First one is single bolted lap joint and double bolted lap joint. So there are the two type in lap connection. Second one is butt connection. So again, there are the two type in butt joint also, single cover butt joint and double cover butt joint. So as per the force is concerned, we use these two types of connection. Now what is lap joint? So in case of lap joint, two member are overlap and connected by means of bolt or weld is called lap joint. So when two member are connected by one line of a bolt, it is called lap joint. Now what is butt joint? So in this joint, the two mains plate against each other and additional cover plate are provided on either side of or both side, so is called butt joint. So third one is tension connection and tension plus shear connection. So we can use this joint against shear or tension connection of joints. Force transfer mechanism. So there are the first case, bearing connection. So in that, force are transferred to the bearing stress. Second one is friction connection. So there are the clamping force also occur and friction force is denoted by T. So in this case, bolt shear are transferred in a friction connection. So you can see the free body diagram against friction load and clamping force P0. Next, failure of this connection. So how many types of failure connection are there? So various mode of failure of bolted joint are there. First one is shearing of bolt. Second one is bearing of bolt. Third one is tensile force of bolt. Same are occurs in plate also. So start with the bolt. First one is shearing of bolt. So there are the shear force in different opposite side. You can see the effect of shearing of bolt. And after the shearing, you can see the figure of bolt, how it should be changed. So diameter should be change of bolt. Again, bearing fracture. So you can see the bearing force also. These are the bearing fractures and bearing yield. So our diameter of all are under in bearing force. So same occurs in plate also. So you can see the plate of bearing force. So these are the two main failure that will be conduct in our example also, shearing of bolt and bearing of bolt. So what is bearing joints? So in a bearing joint, the conducted elements are assumed to be slip into bearing against the body of the bolt. If joint is designed as a bearing joint, the load is transferred through the bearing where the bolt is installed tight in a, see this figure. These are the shear plate against bearing plate. So we check these two failure, either your bolt should be in shearing failure or your bolt should be in bearing failure. So we can design as per this failure of joints. Next, we can see thread in a shear plane. So the shear plane is between two or more pieces under the load, where the pieces tend to move parallel from the each other but in opposite direction. So these are the shear plane. So the threaded of bolt may either including the shear plan or exclude from the shear plan. So the capacity of bolt is greater with thread excluding from the shear plan. So in previous video session we see about the plan of bolt. So there are the mainly two plan. One is threaded area and second one is shank area. So if your shear plan are connected to threaded part, so your bearing capacity should be increased. So that's why we touch with the plate in the threaded area, and as per the threaded area we decide the shear plan generated to the connection. Next, caudal requirement of bolted connection. So clearance of fastener of bolt is given in clause number 10.2.1. so it depends upon the diameter of bolt. So if your bolt diameter is 12 to 14 mm, the standard clearance is 1. If your bolt diameter 16 to 22, standard clearance is 2. Now minimum spacing. So minimum spacing, you can say pitch distance between two center bolt is given in clause number 10.2.2. So minimum pitch distance should be 2.5 times D, where D is a nominal diameter of fastener. Now maximum spacing. So in general, maximum spacing is given in clause number 10.2.3 is equal to 32 times T or 300 mm, whichever is less. For tension member, maximum pitch is equal to 16 times T or 200 mm, whichever is less. And for the compression member, maximum pitch is 12 times T or 200 mm, whichever is less. So there are these three criteria to provide the maximum distance between center to center bolt is called pitch. So general criteria, while the connection is using in a tension, then criteria should be changed. While your connection using compression load, then again criteria should be changed. So for fastener in a line edges or parallel in the edge, the outside plate should be provided to maintain this maximum spacing. Next one is edge distance, or you can say end distance of bolt. So you can see the figure, bolt center to the end of your plate is called end distance, or you can say edge distance. So edge distance is equal to 1.5 times of hole diameter in case of rod or machine flame cut is given in clause number 10.2.4. but minimum edge and end distance we have to take 1.7 times hole diameter in case of seared or hand planed cast edge. So in our case we always use 1.7 times diameter of hole, not diameter. Next, effective area of bolt. Now how we calculate effective area of bolt? So is given on clause number 10.3.1. for shear plan, if plan part of the bolt, effective area of bolt is given by the diameter of bolt and at shank area. So effective area is denoted by AE, and equation is generally our circle area, it means pi d square upon 4. So for shear plan, threaded part of bolt, now your plan should be connected in threaded part. So what should be the area is equal to 0.78 ASB. Now ASB is maintained pi by 4 d square. So these are the effective area. Now we calculate our first step, it means design strength of bolt. How can find out design strength of bolt? So our first step, to check the shear capacity of bolt. So clause is given to you 10.3.3 in IS 800. Here the equation is given, VNSB is equal to FUB under root 3 NN into ANB plus NS into ASB. Now where ASB is nominal plank shank area, it means pi by 4 d square. AN, it means net shear area bolt at threaded corresponding to the plane. So it means 0.78 pi by 4 d square. FUB, ultimate tensile strength of bolt. NN, number of shear plane with threaded intersecting. NS, number of plane without threading intersecting. Next, shear capacity of bolt. After find out VNSB, we got VDSB, it means design shear capacity of bolt. So VNSB divided by partial safety factor. So finally we calculate shear capacity of bolt. Same way, our second step, bearing capacity of bolt, is given to you clause number 10.3.4, and the equation for bearing capacity. So first we find out V and PB, 2.5 times KB into D into T into FU, where KB is, here you calculate 4 value, and smaller of these 4 you take as a KB. First one is E upon 3D0, E means edge distance. Second one is P upon 3D0 minus 0.25, it means pitch distance. FUB, it means ultimate strength of bolt. Normal FU, it means ultimate strength of steel. And 1. D0, it means diameter of bolt hole. And T is thickness of connecting plate. After find out V and PB, we finally design strength of bolt decided. So here, bearing capacity VDPB is equal to V and PB divided by gamma MB is nothing but partial safety factor. So now design strength of bolt is given in clause number 10.3.2. So design strength of bolt is denoted by VDB, and VDB shall be taken as smaller of these two value, which first one is shearing capacity, it means VDSB, and second one is bearing capacity VDPB. So designing of strength of bolt, we first calculate shear capacity of bolt, and second we calculate bearing capacity of bolt. After that, whichever is small is denoted as design strength of bolt, or you can say the strength of bolt. Now next is design strength of bolt due to tension capacity. So it's given in clause number 10.3.4. Nominal tension capacity of bolt is denoted by T and B is equal to 0.9 times FUB into AN, and it should be less than or equal to FYB into partial safety factor divided by ASB into partial safety factor. So finally, design tension capacity of bolt TDB is denoted by TNB divided by gamma NB. Now what should be TNB? So TNB is nothing but nominal tension capacity of bolt. So first we find out TNB. So we finally got tension capacity of bolt is denoted by TDB. So start with our first exam. The data is given to you. Determine the bolt value of 16 mm diameter of bolt, 4.6 grade of connecting, 8 mm thick plate of 410 grade in single shear and double shear. So first of all, according to grade of bolt, we decide FUB and FYB. It means ultimate strength of bolt and yield strength of bolt. So 4.6, it means 400 MPa ultimate strength, and 60% of FUB, it means FY should be 240 MPa. Now we calculate ASB, nominal sink area pi by 4 D square, it means 201 mm square, and ANB, it means net area connecting to the thread area. So 0.70 times ASB, it means 156 mm square. Next, first we find out shear capacity of bolt VDSB. So we know that the equation of VDSB, clause number 10.2.3, we got 28.8 kN in single shear. How we calculate? So here NN should be 1 in single shear. If you calculate in double shear, your NN should be 2. Now in lap joint, we assume that all plates are connected in threaded area. So this portion of ANS into ASB is 0. It will be taken in butt joint. So in lap joint, only you calculate value of NN. In single shear, it should be a 1. In double shear, it should be a 2. So value should be double. And next we calculate bearing strength of bolt VDPB. So is also given in clause number 10.3.3. Smaller of these two value is our bolt value. So in single shear, our bolt value is 28.8, and the double shear also our bolt value is 57.6, because you can see that value of shear capacity and bearing capacity, the minimum is shear capacity. It means our joints are fail under shear capacity. So who should provide the bolted connection as per the shear capacity? So just you have to take on the two steps, shear capacity of bolt and bearing capacity of bolt. Next example, Design a lap joint between plate of size 80 by 10 mm and 80 by 8 mm thick as to transport factor load of 80 kN using single row of bolt 4.6 grade of bolt and 410 plate. So same, first according to grade of bolt we decide FUB, FYB. According to diameter is given, so we decide diameter of hole. So as per the table of IS 800, diameter of hole plus add clearance, so we got diameter of hole. Then we calculate edge distance, pitch distance, ASB and ANB. These are the preliminary calculation in every example you have to done. Next, it means our first step, shear and capacity of bolt. So the same equation we have to use, clause number 10.2.3. In single shear, the value should be 28.8. Now we calculate bearing capacity. So before find out bearing capacity, we know the value of KB. So four value of KB is given in the same clause. So first value is 0.65, second value is 0.49, third value is 0.98 and fourth value in 1. So smaller if this 4, you can see the value is 0.45. So we take KB is equal to 0.49. So now we find out bearing capacity and we got the value of 51.43. So now we decide bolt value, it means strength of bolt. So minimum of these two values, shearing and bearing. So our bolt value is 28.8 kN. Now in data, the tension load is given to you. So we can find out number of bolt. How can find out? So number of bolt is equal to total load divided by bolt value. So our number total load is 80 kN. Bolt value is 28.8. So we required three numbers of bolt to connect these two plate under tension load. So just three step you have to calculate in this example while we given the total load. So last step is our number of bolt. First two step are common, shearing capacity and bearing capacity. So these are the example of tension member. Again we take third example, so you can more conceptualize about the design of bolt. This one is take as a butt joint. So bridge truss diagonal carries axial pull of 250 kN. Two plates of 200 by 10 mm and 200 by 16 mm are required to be joined together by butt joint. Here you have to check that the joint is given is butt joint. Previous two example are sold under lap joint. So design suitable double cover butt joint, it means you should provide the cover plate on top and bottom. Bore broad grade 4.6 and plate grade 410. Same procedure, our preliminary calculation first we have to done. It means after given the grading of bolt, you should decide FUB, FYB. According to diameter, decide diameter of hole, edge distance, pitch distance, ASB and ANB. We already discussed about this equation. You can see in this figure two plates are given, in that we provide cover plate. So according to our calculation, our edge distance is 35 and pitch distance is 40 and total load is given 250 kN as a tension. So first we calculate shear capacity of bolt. So here there are two cover plates, so NN should be double. So provide the NN is equal to 2. Here in butt joint we assume that one plate are connected into AN and one plate are connected to ANS, it means shank area and thread area. So put the value of NN is equal to 1 and NS is equal to 1. We already calculate ANB and ASB. So finally we get single shear value of tension, it means shear capacity, is means 19.55 kN. Again our next step is bearing capacity of bolt. Before find out bearing capacity, we should calculate four value of KB, and smaller of these four is our KB. So in this case smaller is 0.58, so we take KB is equal to 0.58. now we calculate bearing capacity of bolt and we calculate 152.19 kN for 16 mm bolt. So we know that bolt value is smaller of shear and bearing, so it of course our shear value. So number of bolt is equal to total load divided by bolt value. So total load is given 250 kN divided by bolt value. So we required three numbers of bolt for connecting these two plate as a butt joint. Here it not mentioned to design a cover plate, so you doesn't worried about design of cover plate, just put these two plate and repeated these two steps: shear capacity of bolt, bearing capacity of bolt, and number of bolt. Thank you, friends.